Okay, so somebody on the Xbox page for Ark has just, or PC unofficial page for Ark has just requested that how to make dice and convert them to convert images to canvas. So, first and first, No snap point. I do have my gamma up right now, so I apologise for the pulling. Fecal squirting, but diarrhea, which is a dye making thing via S plus and silk smooth. Just need 255, I think, dyes, which we've crafted now. So, I'm going to pause this and we'll jump forward over to when that's ready. Right, so. Leaving off, starting from where we left off, like that, and I've now made this. So, this pulls water from the atmosphere, which is quite magical. So, I'm going to say I want 5 of each. And jumping back in, and as you can see, we have the dice crafted. So, I'm taking them to my inventory. And of course, we're going to need a paint wash. And canvases, of course, which I don't actually have anything back for in this, so I will be grabbing them. This is where we're going to need I walk and walk often. First of all, your paintbrush. So then you have to consider what you actually want on your canvas. So let's pull up. There we go. This is just an explanation how to import paint for the Argon Atlas 2. I haven't actually searched this. Two different converters, one for each game. Yes, there is a different converter for Atlas than there is. Arc. So on my desktop I have an Arc folder and where is it? Atlas, no, Arc convert, there we go. So this is the converter. However, I'm not going to be using that just yet. We're going to be using this for basic picture. So let's say, I don't know, something creative. Marvel. That's not a very good result. There we go. Now, you don't want too much blatant detail. Because the conversion is... There we go. So that's not really very good for canvas format. Well, we could use the Avengers, maybe. If not, let's try Scarlet Witch. No, that's still off. You won't want similar dimensions to the canvas that you're using. There we go, Marvel United, that looks perfect. Save image as, no, I don't want to do that, so click on that. It's going to take me to a miniaturized version of it, most likely. There we go. Save image as, no. See, this is a problem with finding a picture on Google. There we go. So this is going to be my Atlas paintings. So that's not particularly where I want it. So what we'll do is, oh, let's take me straight to Atlas. So this is set to flak, so what I want to do, look on this, dyno and canvas, there we go. So what we want to do is, as you see, all colours are checked, but we don't want to be using all colours. The more colours that are there, that means the more paints that you're going to have to create. So reduce, and that was basically reduce a little more. That's as low as it'd prefer to go. So what you then do is save as a PNG file. Well, I don't want it in Atlas, you see. I want it in Arc. Save my paintings. And we're going to want this here. So that's that. And then I'm going to change our first bit to model test. So hopefully we'll go back in game. Should come up. Marvel test, here we go. And the colours required here. Click load painting. Unfortunately, it does take a little time. Meanwhile, to our sponsors of Fleas and Ticks, I'm only joking. Just a typical YouTube advert, you gotta love them. But back to the music. So yeah, the more details and stuff you give a painting, the longer it's going to take. And here you go. Marvel Studios, Mary. And there you have it. So for anybody else who wants to take this painting or learn this painting from you, what they would then do is hit it with a paintbrush meaning your tribe or whatnot, and then they would save that painting and name it as they choose. And that's how you can get more people access to that painting file that will then save in their local files. As I said, you'll see that there's quite a bit of quality loss there. So when you go to like choosing paintings and that. There's been some Edwards classic one that's been done for a while. I did not make this one, however I did download it from arcpaint.net or arc warpaints, I can't remember which. Both fantastic websites with a lot of dedicated artists out there. And some, you know, maybe not some artists, but copy and paste is such a fine method because I cannot draw fuck well. But there you go. But when you're doing cartoon-like things, it's one thing, but when you go to real people and real things with, like, high resolutions and you compress them down, you'll see what happens to all Beetlejuice here. Now, a good way to try and save some resolutions is to do a multi-canvas. Now, to do a multi-canvas, remember you'll always be working in the dimensions to which you choose. So, you know, as you can see, that's a lot of quality loss. It doesn't look very... You can see what it is if you know what it is, of course, but, you know, you want the best quality you possibly can. But if you were doing a multi-canvas, for example, I'll remove that. You would have it. Like that. Instead of your picture taking just one of those, it would then take up all four. Therefore, you're getting a bigger picture. However, some art mods do have larger canvases, like the Echoes as Deco mods, which you can then customize for the larger canvas by making your own template for said piece. Well, it really is as easy as that, guys. I'm Bacchus, aka Turek, of Noobs Rising server. Fantastic cluster. Have fun.